What's up, guys? It's your boy Spider Productions here, and today we are here with the next episode of The Flash. This is season 8, episode 14, Funeral for a Friend. So, guys, I wanted to just say that I apologize that I didn't react to this when it first came out. I was still in the process of unpacking all of my stuff when we moved into our new place. And not only that, I was, you know, taking into the fact that it's summertime for me now, so I have more free time. So I've been taking much needed breaks. I still have been obviously recording and posting still, but not as many videos that I would have liked to do. So I've been mainly focusing on posting videos from, you know, trailer reactions and videos that Rockstar has posted, but I haven't really posted any like TV show reactions, and for that I want to apologize. So we're gonna be doing a lot of stuff today. So today we're going to be reacting to two episodes of The Flash, the one that I missed last week and the one that came out last night. Then I'm going to react to the new episode of Young Justice, and then I need to react to that multiverse video game cinematic trailer that came out a couple days ago. Didn't see that. And then we're going to play through Lego Star Wars also, because this weekend I'm going to be busy. Friday I'm going to spend time with my dad, and then Saturday I'm going to spend time with a friend, so I'm not going to have time to do any other videos. So basically it's just a video day. We're just going to be posting and bombarding videos all day. So hope you guys enjoy all the extra content. I hope you do, because it's going to be a lot for me. So without further ado, so if I remember correctly, yes, last week or 2 weeks ago, Killer Frost died. It was not something I was expecting, and she turned into Death Frost, I think is what she was called. But yeah, she sacrificed herself to defeat Deathstorm, and she died. It was not something I was expecting, but yeah, Frost died, and then what else happened in that episode? Iris had a run-in with Eddie Thawne, who we have not seen her and Iris together since season 1, so that was pretty cool. It looks like Iris is still dealing with her Speed Force or Still Force disease, or her time sickness, I think that's what it's called. So without further ado, we're gonna see what they gave us this episode that I missed. So let's jump right in. Chester. Killer Frost, Kid Flash, Clyde Pacino. Doing here. Jesus! Oh yeah, no frost. Oh, Jesus! Everybody's still dealing with the fallout with frost. Not ready to go in a field. Blockbuster? That's who that's supposed to be? Thank you. Ross convinced him to do art. That's crazy. Thank you. cool they're having a lot of people listen outside. That sounds like something she'd say. I'm glad that they're dedicating this episode to Frost, because I feel like Frost has been one of those characters that did have appreciation, but she wasn't really the focal point. She didn't get as much appreciation all the time, so I'm glad that she definitely got that. Good man. Really that killer. Oh, so we're getting the focus on different characters throughout the episode. Yeah, they do have an eternal flame for Oliver, but I don't think that you'd be able to do the same. And plus, where would you put it? My God! Are y'all really arguing about this food nonsense? Fighting over fucking sauce.
Sculpting, building a snowman, and doing
understand why she is the one that's the most hurt out of everything.
Thank you.
Yeah, I keep forgetting the captain knows that Barry's the Flash. Because we haven't really seen her do any training. Was this soon?
Thank you.
She does. Oh man, they did that off screen. Yeah. I mean, I guess he wasn't that significant of a bad guy, but still, I would like to see that on screen. So, Kaitlyn's gonna try to bring Frost back. Peace out.